All right, here we are for game one. We're on the draw. And I think this hand is good enough to keep. We have a turn three Coatl or Mach to Rioters, which is going to be a 3-3 or a 4-4 at the time. Yeah, I think that's pretty clearly going to be good enough. Ooh, even better. So we can cast all of our spells except for the Wildfire now. And we're obviously not really in a rush to Wildfire anyway. Okay. Our opponent has a reassembling skeleton. So now I think we might actually want to lead off with the Frogling now that we've drawn it. We'll have to wait and see what they do. But basically, I would rather. I think we would probably rather expose Frogling to getting blown up. Then expose the Coatl. The only downside is that the Coatl is better the longer it's in play. So maybe we just play, yeah, maybe we just play the Coatl this turn, and then next turn we can play Frogling with mana up to save it. Looks like our opponent is on the Spirits deck, which I think we should be pretty good against. Wildfire is good against them. Necrogenesis is very good, actually, because it can stop the soul shifting. All right, so our Coatl's dying. That's too bad, because our Plaxcaster Frogling would have actually lived through that, and then we could have played the Coatl and immediately put a counter on it. But, oh well, not the end of the world. Frogling will be just fine. And then if we draw a land, we can go like Tribal Flames your guy and play Necrogenesis. Or, oh, we'll figure it out when we get there. All right. Graft is one of the most annoying mechanics of all time on Magic Online, unfortunately. In that it asks you every time you play a spell. Ooh, another Bauble is definitely good. So I think we'll play that and play Necrogenesis this turn. Oh, I should have left up a forest to represent like vines. I think that's the most realistic trick for us to have here. But anyway, I think we're just gonna probably bobble for a mountain, blow up his whole board. I guess then he gets to soul shift back this thing, so maybe we can wait a little bit. We're gonna take a bit of a beatdown from the change or f yeah, from the changeling. But we can go ahead and Tribal Flames it if he pumps at all. Oh, he's attacking with the Kami also. I guess playing Necrogenesis, I kind of forgot that Kami has an activated ability. I guess playing Necrogenesis right into it is a little bit awkward, but we'll still block it for sure. Yeah, so he's just going to pop off our Necrogenesis. That's fine. We'll just draw All Sun's Dawn to get it back. And he's going for the max hit with his Changeling. So I think we want to go ahead and search up another mountain so that we can cast Wildfire if we want to. And let's go ahead and kill this guy. And we could play a 5-5 Mach to Rioters. And then, if we sack Growth Chamber Mountain, like by 5/5, I mean if we graft, and then if we draw one more land, we can actually keep it around. So I think that's what we should do. And I guess we can attack with the frog pretty safely. Maybe we attack next turn. Because if he has a removal spell for the riders, we will want to have the frog around still to block. All right, Restless Apparition is pretty scary. It can be a 6/6 or a 7, 8/8, right? Yeah, it gets +3/+3. Jeez, yeah, that guy's pretty big. Dismember deals with it nicely, though. Not just not yet. So I think we just pass here, and then we can go ahead and block it with Mach the Riders on our turn and dismember it. After he pumps. And again, we're basically just looking for another land. Any land will do. And then we can cast Wildfire and save our Mach the Riders. So he'll pump, we'll dismember in response. There's a chance we could have tried to get him to pump twice, but I think that this is a little safer, just in case of any. I'm not really sure what trick he could have, but some of them could be bad for us potentially. So, if we can get him to commit one more creature, that would be even better. It looks like we are. What are we gonna get? Ooh, that's a very terrifying creature. Any land. All right. So, we cast Wildfire. One, two, three. Four lands. And we'll have a 5/5. Our opponent will get to soul shift back their 2/2, and then eventually reassemble their 1/1. We're just a little bit behind on life, though, unfortunately. Okay, so there's the commie back in business. I guess we might as well play this island. I think, yeah, we can't really race 5 against 2, unfortunately. Spewing off that Necrogenesis was actually pretty painful. Ooh, Scavenging Drake, that's scary. He's going to reassemble his skeleton and peck away. He's actually going to. Oh, I thought he was maybe going to throw away his commie, which we would have been perfectly happy to accept. Because we need to draw a removal spell for this guy anyway, so. So we eat the commie. And now again, if we draw a removal spell, we're still in okay shape. Especially if that removal spell is All Sun's Dawn, because then we can get back Tribal Flames and like all of our other dudes, and it'll be great. Nope. Man, we even are only playing 15 lands. Well, that was rough. All right. So, yeah, playing the Necrogenesis was definitely a big punt. If we could have just eaten all that stuff out of his graveyard, it would have been way better for us. Would Gutshot have been good? Probably not. I think Grim Affliction would, though. I think I'm gonna bring that one in. And so he had his own Grim Affliction. We could cut Dragon Soul Knight. We could just cut. Well, Kozilek's Predator was actually just bigger than like everything he played. So I don't really want to cut that. Maybe we just board out this. It's not really an attacking sort of like. His deck doesn't really build one big creature. It builds, builds the board out rather than up. So I think this might not be that great. Could also be that Arrest is not that good. Yeah, actually we saw the Kami and a Soul Shift guy. I think Arrest is gonna be our worst card. So let's give this a whirl. Alright, here we are for game two. We're on the play. Yeah, this is a different hand than our last one, but it's a beatdown. Noble Hierarch into Mokhtar Rioters into Kozilek's Predator. Don't mind if we do. Ooh, Plagued Drusilka, that can kill our Hierarch. Attacks will definitely block. There's no real reason to take the extra damage for. Okay, if he lets us use the mana on our turn, that's kind of good for us. Kind of assumed he was just going to snap off our Noble Hierarch. But he's thinking about something. Okay, so he did end up snapping us off. That makes sense. Well, Wayfarer's Bauble's not bad. We can go get our mountain and hit for three and set up our predator. Kind of wish we'd ended up. I think I undervalued this card in the draft. It seems like it's actually pretty great in our deck. Ooh. Well, we can play a 3-point Skyreach Manta on our next turn after we play the Predator. Or we can wait and hope to draw a Swamp or a Plains or another Fixer and play an even bigger one. But right now we're kind of just giving the beatdowns anyway. Sure. So we can Burst Lightning with Kicker that guy out of the way too. I think that sounds fine. He gets his Rusulka back, but he takes six. Alternately, I suppose we could just ignore it, play a Skyreach Manta. That actually sounds better. I think getting the Manta into play is better, and we can just save all this burn for his face. Even if it is only a lowly 3/3 Skyreach Manta. We don't really have to deal that much damage when we have 7 points of burn floating around in our hand. Alright, doubling down on the Striders. That was a great draw, because now our Rioters is big enough to force him to block. If he wants to chump block, he can. But it is a chump block now as opposed to a free block. Yeah, he's gonna go for it anyway. Okay, Scavenger Drake in there. Tapped his mana kind of awkwardly. So I think I'm just gonna bolt down the Scavenger Drake. Well, maybe that's not even good. He's probably not gonna chump with it, right? He can't have t he can't he doesn't have any way to cause two creatures to die on his turn. So yeah, I'm just gonna hope he doesn't chump with it and that we can just kill him. Wildfire can be an insurance plan if we need it. Yeah, he's just trying to get his Drake as big as possible. But we have enough burn to finish the job. Just send it all upstairs. Okay, that worked out pretty well. So Rapid Flames might be a card that I... Well, no, probably still not good. Instill Infection might be better, or Shrivel. I guess if we want Rapid Flames, we'd just rather have Shrivel. I'm not sure if we want Shrivel. It does kill the Drake. But, and it kills the Rusulka. That's it. Yeah, I don't know if that's good enough. It's probably not. All of our spells are like pretty high impact. Yeah, I'm just gonna stick with it as is, I think. All right, here we are for game three. We're on the draw. I think this hand is also a keep. We can, if we get a blue source, which we have about, we have two islands, a Simic Growth Chamber, a Noble Hierarch, so that's four, and then three Bauble and a Rampant Growth, so eight of them. Then we can have a turn three Frogling and then Grim Affliction to proliferate them, which is super good. And if not, we have Grim Affliction and then maybe like Wildfire to mop up. So I think this hand's okay. Wildfire is a little awkward against his deck because he has all the Soul Shift stuff. Okay. Ugh. The third mountain is pretty terrible. So I think, yeah, I think we probably just snap off his Thief of Hope before he can get, you know, get too much value out of it. Sucks to lose out on proliferating our guys, but I think Thief of Hope is like really good in his deck, so we don't want to just take a lot from it. All right, we've now drawn all but one of our mountains. Unfortunately. Fortunately, he's not really doing anything either. That's a something. I don't really want to just play a 3/3 Skyreach Manta because I think we're just casting Wildfire next turn anyway, probably. Hope we're hoping our opponent doesn't play one of the 1/4 Soul Shift guys because that would save his vampires, which would be pretty annoying. That thing is more okay. So, yeah, I guess we just Wildfire. And we can sack, like, all of our mountains. Opponent, unfortunately, gets to keep his Basilica, which is pretty strong, but if we draw. If we draw anything good, we're actually in okay shape. Like, if we just draw a rampant growth effect or an island, either one would be just fine. Ooh, that's not bad either, actually. He has three creatures in his yard. He's just making a 4/4 and smashing us. Ooh, all right, let's kill that thing. Well, I guess actually we might as well. Well, no, we should just kill it now, probably. Yeah, we might as well wait. We'll just Necrogenesis it. And we'll Necrogenesis block and maybe eat his turn's worth of mana as well, if we're lucky. We'll start with the cheap. I guess we want. Thief of Hope is the most annoying if he returns it, so that's the one we'll start with. Plagued Rusalka is like okay if he gets to return it, but not that big a deal. So he's gonna go ahead and pump. We burst lightning. And we got to eat his turn. That's pretty good. Nice. Island is very good. We can get a frogling in there. And I guess we might as well attack with our sapperling. There's no real risk. So now we can maybe play a protected Skyreach Manta later with the frogling. That's pretty sweet. If our opponent just passes here, I'm going to go ahead and make a thing anyway. Okay. We do not want to graft onto your Daggerclaw Imp. Thank you, though. Now we'll hit his Rusalka. And don't really want to graft onto our Sapperling. So I guess we go ahead and hit for probably just one. I guess getting hit back for one is not that big a deal. If he has a removal spell, it kills our Frogling. And unfortunately, we just have to play the Manta with no real backup. And hope that it's good enough. I don't think we want to graft onto it. I guess we could, and then he can't trade Imp. He can't even trade Imp plus Rusalka for it. Yeah, that actually sounds good. Because we have another Frogling anyway, so having the ground locked up is not going to be that difficult. But a rest or something would be very bad for us here. We'd have to draw a removal spell quick. Alright, Hikari is, no picnic for us, but not the end of the world, because that means we're going to get to untap, and that means we can protect our Skyreach Manta. So I guess we just go ahead and jam this Soul Eater, and that way if we draw the plains, it's very good. We can save ourselves some damage that way. I'm going to go ahead and move a counter there, too, so we can keep it protected as well. And then I think we're going to set a trap by by activating Necrogenesis at the end of our opponent's turn. Because we're actually pretty happy if he uses Plagued Rusalka to kill off the Plaxcaster Frogling. That's not really a big deal for us, because we have another one in reserve. So I'd actually be happy if he did that. Scuttling death. So let's see if he blinks. And then I guess we should respond to this by eating his restless apparition so that he can't regrow it. He can kill our Plaxcaster Frogling now if he wants, then. It's not really that big a deal. Yeah. Well, then if he just attacks us with both of his guys. Yeah, actually, that's pretty bad for us. I'm thinking then if he just attacks with Hikari, we block, he gives it minus one, and there's nothing we can really do about that. Yeah, I guess we just have to let it resolve then. Not grafting onto it. So now we're probably going to end up trading Skyreach Manta for Rasulka, Scuttling Death, and Hikari. Which is, I mean, all things considered, that's not the worst trade in the world. He gets back his Restless Apparition as well, but that doesn't really do that much because we have the ground so sewn up with Necrogenesis. And then we're just going to have to draw a removal spell for this imp. If he makes this attack. If he doesn't make the attack, then that's fine too. All right, so he decided to go with it. And as expected, he's going to try and shrink our guy. We give it Hexproof in response, then he sacrifices the Scuttling Death. And probably gets back this apparition. Yep. All right. Nice. All right, so now we can keep the Daggerclaw Imp dealt with. Might as well play our Rioters. Not move a counter. And hit for three. So we'll tap down his guy. And then we'll go ahead and make another Necrogenesis token off of his Plagued Rusulka, I suppose. The apparition has arrived. And what else do you got? So we'll respond to that one by offing that Rusulka. Fortunately, this guy is colorless. Although he is, yeah, we are in a bit of trouble now. Because he can just give his Restless Apparition pro green, and that actually gets through our whole board, which is a bit problematic. So I guess we have to tap down Restless Apparition this next turn. Maybe I should have put a plus one counter on the Restless Apparition, actually. Looking at it, yeah, wasn't really thinking about that, but I think that would have made a lot of sense. May as well attack with the rioters anyway, because we're going to just be tapping down the Restless Apparition. Yeah, that was definitely that definitely would have been better. He does actually have to be a little bit careful, or he could just get killed too. Like if he, I get, yeah, let's see if we can, maybe I should have attacked with the saplings last turn actually. Would have dealt a bit more damage. Uh-oh, what's this? A Baku. That's weird, it didn't trigger my grafts. I wonder why. Okay, so we could cast Tezzeret's Gambit for 2 life. Tap down his Wax Mane Baku, and then he's taking. He has to block one of the big guys, right? At that point. But then we die to the Dagger Claw Imp. So I guess I should just cast the Gambit for mana. Leaving red up for ourselves. And then if we draw a Bolt or something, we can still pay 2 life or pay a mana to tap down the Baku. Then he chump blocks the Mokhtar Riders, takes 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So he dies to Bolt if we do that. Okay. It's good to have outs. Does not qualify, unfortunately. So what happens if we just attack with everybody? He probably blocks. Well, let's attack with all. We'll attack with all of the non-blinding Soul Eater creatures we have and see what he does. He definitely has to be at least somewhat concerned of another Bolt or another Burst Lightning or something like that, or Tribal Flames. We've shown him all of those cards. So if we can get his Moonlit Strider to die in combat here, then we have a chance to still win. This is how he's gonna block? He doesn't beat anything with this block. Yeah, basically we have to sell him on trying to beat Tribal Flames, which he can't do. So yeah, this is what we needed. Perfect. So he's going to sack Moonlit Strider, presumably to give the Baku pro green. And then we're going to pay 2 life to tap down his Daggerclaw Imp. And activate Necrogenesis twice, chump block both of his guys. I guess we actually, it's better to not pay the 2 life. Oh, no! Oh, that was what we needed to not have happen. So now, yep, we're actually just dead. That stinks. If he, because now he can just remove a counter to tap one of our guys, and we're dead. Well, that really stinks. I feel like we played that game pretty well, actually. And our opponent made the key mistake we needed him to make, but then drew out of it, unfortunately. Yep. Yeah, I don't think we could have attacked with less, because I think that still leaves us dead. Well, that was rough, but thanks for watching, guys, and I'll be back next week.